And we open this edition with the resurgence of piracy off the coast of Somalia. Since November 2023, multiple incidents and hijackings have taken place in the Somali Basin. Several potential pirate camps have been identified on the coast between Xaafun and the village of Garacad. Their activities can take them up to more than 600 nautical miles from eastern Somalia. Our correspondent Abdulkadir Fooday has been following the efforts of the Puntland Maritime Police to combat this threat and filmed this report. Puntland Maritime Police forces are stepping up their fight against the resurgence of piracy off the coast of Somalia. Officers say this action comes in response to recent incidents where pirates have hijacked vessels, posing a renewed threat to the global economy and particularly impacting Somalia's economic stability. The forces are now actively working to curb this piratical revival by safeguarding maritime traffic, especially ensuring the protection of ships docking at Bosaso Port, Puntland's commercial hub.
Pirates are back due to the election time in Puntland, because the government was facilitating elections and many challenges were surrounding the authorities, whether they were from the opposition or from the terrorism. So the government focused on the land. Now we have orders to finish them. They don't have power, only sneaking in small groups like 2, 3, 5 or 10 individuals and God willing. We will end them soon.
Pirates venturing into distant waters to hijack ships complicates the mission of the Puntland's maritime forces. However, the drive to protect Somalia's economy energizes them to persist in their maritime patrols.
They have started hijacking from far waters about 700, 800 or 1,000 miles. Fuel crept to most ships, but I'm announcing here to the businessmen that they keep doing their business. And from today onwards, they shouldn't fear piracy.
Businesses operating in the bustling Bosaso port significantly upgraded by a $366 million investment from Dubai's DP World have found it easier to import goods into the country, turning the port into a critical hub of trade. However, there's growing concern among these business owners due to recent pirate attacks, fearing these incidents could disrupt their operations and impact trade in the future.
So far, we're not affected by these activities, but only God knows what will happen later in the future. If things go worse and this continues, it is possible that we will be affected. We now have forces to protect the area and escort ships. They don't go to Yemen waters. They consistently work within the Puntland border.
Somalia, grappling with significant food security challenges, heavily relies on imports to meet its essential needs. The nation's main import partners include the United Arab Emirates, China and Oman, among others, with food and fuel constituting the core of these imports. This reliance underscores the critical nature of international trade for Somalia's sustenance and energy requirements. An independent economic expert has warned of the ongoing threat of piracy, emphasizing its potential to disrupt Somalia's access to essential imports. Given the nation's reliance on overseas products ranging from food to clothing, and interference with shipping could lead to shortages and inflated prices.
This problem could have an impact on the population because our life depends on imported goods and local production is scarce. This leads to price hiking because ships and logistic cargo companies will refuse to come to Somalia. The reason they do that is because international ships have insurance. So the companies give them that insurance and don't allow them to go to places with piracy risks because they know that they will face huge losses, hence they don't give insurance to the ships that go to Somalia.
Pirates have resumed hijacking ships, including the MV Ruin, a Maltese flagged cargo vessel. In March, The Indian Navy freed the ship along with its 17 crew members after a three-month capture. Puntland's maritime police are actively pursuing pirates to ensure safer seas for navigation.